Hello guys, welcome back to the next session of ABAP 100 training series. Thank you for choosing the tutorials. So in the previous session, we left at the discussion of declarative logic. Okay, so let's start this. As we have discussed about these types of statements, we are having two types of statements. One is declarative logic and another is imperative logic. So in this session, we will discuss about the preview of this declarative logic. Okay. So how we write SQL scripts? Okay. That's so that these are sequences of SQL statements. Okay. How we write our select query. Okay. How we write SQL script. That will be already, it's simply if you will understand it that we have to write in some flow only. Okay. SQL script statements which are plugged together. So for example, I have my query, one which is like, let's say, selecting from some table. Let's say, let me insert this. Okay. Let's write some, what is that? Yeah. Query one. Okay. Let's say, what I will do here is, simply what I will do. So my SQL query, let's say, WT material. What we used to do? Select star from mother. Simple. Okay. Or if you want to give any condition where network should be greater than 1000. Okay. Let's say I will write my query number 2. Okay. What I will write here is, let's say I will write my sales LT underscore. Sales, okay, select star from, let's say, BBAP, okay, where material, what is a matner, okay, in, let's say, I will give a condition again here, okay, you select matner, or let's say, we say postner. Okay, from WT material. Okay, is this clear, guys? So simple select queries. Okay, let's say I will say one more select query, query 3. Okay, and I will say as a LT customer. Okay, let's say select star. From, let's say, what is that? Customer, KNA1, HANA, where KUNNR, okay, in, where it should be in, select, let's say, okay, select, matner, or, okay, let's say select matner from WT. Material. Okay. So these SQL statements will be closed by semicolon. Okay. This will be closed with semicolon. So I have my 3 select queries there. Let's say one more select query, guys. Okay. Query number 4. Okay. We have query number 4, and which will tell us the sum of gross amount, okay. Let's say I will tell us LT, LT equals to, let's say WT only here also. Once again, guys, sorry. Yeah. So, in the query 4, that we find as LWT total equals to select sum of network. From select from WT still. So where we are having all the networks. Okay. So these are my 4 select queries. And if you observe carefully, there is the table which is containing the immediate, like intermediate output. And this table is passed. For example, this will table will give you the results. But what this table will do, this table, if you want to fetch the data inside this query tool, so it will check query one. Now the question is, okay, because we are fetching the data on basis of this only, okay. Now my question is, guys, let's say material here, okay. So my question is for you, can query one and query two be processed parallelly? Can you run query two before running query one? Is this possible, guys? Can you run this query two before query one? No, you cannot. Look here, you cannot, guys, okay. Here, how can you do that here? This is needed. This is needed until you finish this one, okay. This is needed until you finish this one. So you cannot run query two before query one. Okay. Is this clear? Nothing, don't get confused here. Now the next question is, can you run query three before query one? No, because here again, No, because again, you can see this is selecting the data from there. Without this query, you cannot run this. Correct? Now, next question is, okay, can you run query 2 and query 3 parallelly? Can you run query 2 and query 3 parallelly? Yes, after processing query 1, query 2 and query 3 can be processed in parallel because they are not dependent on each other, okay? Yet they are dependent on query 1, but after query 1, these two queries can run parallelly, okay? Hence, I would say query 1 runs first, and once it's finished, it can run it in parallel from query 2 and query 2, 3. Okay, I hope this one is clear, guys. Which means HANA can process this branch by one of the core, and this branch by another core of the core. Okay, this branch, let me create something. Okay. So this is my, let's say, query one. Okay. This is my, I'm taking it as a main query mine here. Okay. Here, query two. Here, query three. Okay. So this query three. Okay. So this query one is, this query 2 and query 3 both are dependent. So what I will do is that, okay, let's make a query. Oh, one second, guys. Yeah. So this is the main relation through this, okay. Okay, so this query 1 and query 2, okay, how they are running? They are dependent on query 1. Now, my next question is, can you run query 4 before query 2? No, you cannot run, okay, because they are dependent on each other, okay. And one more thing, can you run query 4 before query 1? No, because this is dependent on query 2. And this query 2 is dependent on where? This query 2 is dependent on query 1. Okay. So if I will make one more relation here. So this is my query 4. Okay. So on this query 4, I will do go there. Yeah. So on this query 4, don't get confused. I don't get bored here. Okay. Okay, on this query 4 is dependent on query 2, and this query 2 is dependent on query 1. And then at the last, how will I get the result? Here. So these are all what are they doing? One second. Okay, now you cannot run query 4 before running query 1, okay, because it's mandatory to finish query, to which it means in further, if I draw it from my data flow graph, this is my data flow graph, okay. Possibly, HANA can run things in parallel if you have declarative logic, declarative type of logic written in parallel script. Okay. Now don't worry about this syntax. We will discuss about this index in like depth more in future. Okay. I hope this one is clear, guys. So this is what about our data flow logic. Okay. So guys, that's all for this session. Have a good day. Bye bye.